Hi, hey guys, my name is Whitney. Welcome back to my channel, and welcome if you are new. I am a fashion reseller and soon to be professional organizer, and hence why you see this video. I am getting ready to organize my refrigerator and my pantry area as well, but I'm gonna record that as a separate video just for the sake of time. If you saw my last video and how absolutely crazy it was, you saw the haul of all of these items already, and then you also saw my son a lot, but he is taking a nap right now. Hallelujah. So I'm gonna figure out how I'm gonna use all of this stuff. Obviously, I'm not gonna use it all because it's too much to go in my refrigerator. It's not that big, but you guys will see the whole process. I'm gonna take you guys over there. We're gonna take everything out, organize it, and put it all back in. So stay tuned, and I hope you like what you see. Okay, guys, so this is my refrigerator. This is what it looks on the outside. Not very organized at all, but I have a 2-year-old, so. And the inside is even worse. Plus, to me it's small. I don't know about anybody else, but to me the narrowness of it kind of sucks a little bit, but I'm gonna make it work. So we're gonna focus mainly on this part right now. I did get like squeeze bottle containers for the stuff on the door, but they don't arrive until tomorrow, so I'm gonna just have to do that tomorrow, and I guess I'll just film or take a picture of the complete final result tomorrow. So let's just start by taking all the stuff up. Saw that video a few days ago or so, and I could have sworn I had purchased a egg container, like the acrylic egg container, see-through one, but I did not. I'm kind of upset because I had the opportunity to get one from TJ Maxx yesterday, but I didn't get it, obviously, because I thought I already had one. So I'm gonna have to go back and get another one. So maybe I'll get that one today or tomorrow as well. That way, when I do the door, y'all can really see the finished product, and I'm still not having to say, oh, but I still don't have the egg thing. I don't want to have to deal with that. I just want to do it all at the same time. So we purchased this refrigerator because this house didn't come with a refrigerator, and I didn't realize until like a month or two in, or maybe a month and a half in, that this whole drawer does not even belong to this refrigerator. Like, it just sits there at the bottom, and it's just there. So I pull it out, and you gotta be super careful when you pull it out because there's nothing attached to it, so it'll just fall down if you don't do it properly. But now that I'm looking at the refrigerator, I honestly don't think I might even put it back in. Oh snap. It's just a wet spot from washing the dishes. Yeah, Yeah, I'm gonna rearrange the shelves. So I think I'm gonna do it one at a time. Man, I don't know. I don't know. A part of me wants to just rearrange it to be evenly spaced, and a part of me wants to do it like as I go. So I know for sure I want to raise this up a little bit higher because I know I don't need like this extra space up here because this is where the drinks will be. But then on the rest of the shows, I'm not sure how much space I'm gonna need. How does that work? Okay, yeah, so I think I'm gonna adjust this, take these two out. This just has to stay here, and so does that. And then as I start to build in, I'm gonna add these back in where they should go. So, time for the speed through. Actually, I think I might put this one even higher and have this as a shorter shelf, and the next one be the larger, wider shelf. And then I realized this is gonna be in the refrigerator for like 3 more days because I'm building him a bar area upstairs. So I'm gonna just lay this down somewhere and use like my milk cartons or something like that to have a, to be a guide for how I'm going to do the show. Make my lemon water, my lemon, cucumber, lime. I'm not gonna do any mint now because my mint, what do I call it? My mint plant died a little and I'm hoping I can revive it. I'm not even sure if that's possible because I don't know nothing about plants. So I'm just gonna let that be, but I am gonna put the lime, lemon, and cucumber. Hello. Have you ever been interested in learning how to make lemon lime cucumber water? Well, if so, this is the video for you. So, in order to make lemon lime cucumber water, you're gonna need the container that you're making it in, your lemons and limes, and your cucumber. Let me go grab my cucumber. Your cucumber. So first things first in this recipe is you wanna wash your produce, even the lemons and limes. Actually, the limes you may not have to wash, and you'll find out later on why, but definitely your lemons and your cucumber. Let's go wash. Washing. Now, I know a lot of people like to rinse, but personally, I do like to use soap. The soap that I use, EcoSense from Melaleuca, is a biodegradable ingredient and has no ingredients with formaldehyde, phthalates, or parabens. I feel like it's safe enough to wash my produce. Sure, it's better than Dawn. Wash that off. Give it a good rinse.
peel off the stickers of your produce as well. All the corona off. All the other dirt and grime and whatever nastiness there is left on them. Clean it off. Okay. Now, the next step is cutting. So, get out your cutting board. Mine is a flimsy cutting board. Get out your knife, a nice sharp knife, but it doesn't have to be too sharp. And you start cutting. Now, for this size, I'll probably only use about half a cucumber. So I'm just gonna cut half of that and then just put the other half to the side. Take off your little button. And now you're just gonna cut them up in slices. Doesn't really matter the width of the slice, whatever your preference is. You can choose to peel the skin off if you want or not. I just find that's just too much time to do. What's the point? But you can just customize it to however you like. Mines are about a fourth of an inch thick. Maybe even a little bit more. Be careful when you cut this last piece. There you go. Sorry about that. Now you have nicely sliced cucumbers. Now just throw that in there. Next, you're gonna take your lemons. I chose to use 3 lemons because I usually use 2. And the jar that I usually use for my lemon water is this one right here. But as you can see, this is maybe about double the amount, approximately. So I'm just gonna use a little bit extra on the lemons because I love lemons, so I want an extra lemony. I like to take out as many seeds as possible, but if some still gets in there, who cares? You don't have to eat them. Now you just want to squeeze it in. Oopsie, see it right there. Squeeze it good. By the way, guys, don't forget to wash your hands before doing this. You want to get a good squeeze, and sometimes you get your hands all in the lemon and the lime. And you don't want to drink that dirt. Now I like to just drop that in. That simple. On to the next half. Yeah. All right, on to your next lemon. You know, you really can do this with any fruit you have. I'm choosing these fruits is because I am, you know, trying to lose a little weight, some mommy fat. And this is just a good way to burn some extra fat, so. And lastly, you have your you have your lime. Now the only difference with the limes is you're not gonna leave the limes in the tub because I made the mistake of doing that one time. And when I tell you the lime skin left an incredibly bitter taste in the water, it was like undrinkable, in my opinion. I drank it all, but it really made it a lot worse. Lime skin is not the best flavor, so do not leave any of, like, don't leave the skin in there. So try and get as much of the juice out as possible. And I'm just gonna speed through this part because you've already seen everything happen from the other two. Okay, so cleaned off my hands, all the pulp and juice. I decided to just do two limes because I just got tired of squeezing. So it's just gonna be two limes this time. And now you add your water. If you have like a Brita filter or if you have a filter on your sink, feel free to just use that. But because I don't have that, I prefer to use bottled water. And you just pour that in. This holds a whole lot more than I was expecting it to hold. I'm gonna have to grab another jug of water just to fill it all the way up. I think that looks good. Oh, so pulpy, looks just delicious. And if you have it available, use some mint leaves. As you can see, mine is pretty sad right now, so I'm just gonna leave her be for now until she starts to regrow a little bit. Actually, you know what? I'm just gonna use the good ones. Cause you know, why not? It was my fault that, actually, I like to rinse these off too. It was my fault that she died and all the leaves I could have used died right along with her. So I might as well use what I can now, just in case she keeps dying. Really not gonna give that much mint flavor, but some is enough. Just break this little baby off here. Okay. Put you back. Cilantro, I just got yesterday, so she's flourishing. But I need to get her back to that. Now put your top on. Place her in the refrigerator, waits till she gets a little cold, and you're done. Lemon, cucumber, mint, lime water.
So I know earlier I'm hoping that this part of the video didn't get cut out, but if it did, earlier I had said that I usually don't wash all of my produce ahead of time because usually that makes it go to waste faster. But that's probably, from what I believe, that's because it's not usually dried after. So I did wash like my fruits and stuff like that now, but I do plan on making sure everything is dry before putting it back in the refrigerator. So that is the plan for that. I just cleaned off the berries and just letting them air dry for right now until I'm ready to actually place them. And then I'll take some paper towel and actually fully dry them up. I really just want everything to be like easily accessible, just like ready to grab and go kind of thing. That's why this is taking so doggone long. I was not expecting to be doing this for this long. But I did not take in consideration that, one, I had to like wash, well, I knew I had to wash these out, but I didn't realize the amount of time it would take. And then also really would take me longest amount of time is washing out, or washing off all of the produce and stuff. So keep that in mind when you're doing your own kitchen, if you're as extra as me at least.
Okay, so first off, excuse the music in the background. The baby is up now and I can't really be pausing his stuff like I was pausing mine. But I did want to just go in and show y'all so far how I am sorting this stuff out. So on that $9.99 three-set tray, I put all the vegetables. So I have all the cherry tomatoes up top here. The peppers on the top. I really wanted the peppers on the bottom, but they were too bulky and these top trays wouldn't fit right on top. So I just put them up top. And then we have the avocados that are already ripe. That one is out because I need it just to ripen just a little bit more. Cucumbers, zucchini. I mean, I thought I had zucchini, but I guess I didn't buy any. But cucumbers, squash, onion, and a, what are those? Garlic. Then I have the oranges, not oranges, the lemons and the limes. It's not 100% sure if they're going to stay in here, but right now I do like them in there. Then over here, I ended up using this for the grapes. And then we have the salad there. I do have a little bit of salad left in the bin. And I probably just will make a salad tonight to eat. So that's why that's still left in there. And I think that's all for right now. What I am going to do though is go ahead and boil one pack of these eggs so that I can have those hard boiled and put in the refrigerator. And then the rest is still a little bit of a ways to go.
They look like they're for a closet and they're really big and deep, and I wasn't really sure if I wanted to use them for the kitchen, but it's a big old bag of apples and then also potatoes, so I think this would actually be a perfect thing to use. One of these smaller containers, that size, because it's pretty much about the same size as the container it comes in. But because I have two packs of each, I'm gonna put it in the ones that are slightly bigger. Refrigerator nicely. So we have the apples and the pears, the vegetables, the oranges and kiwis, broccoli, the strawberries, the raspberries and blackberries, have the salad all the way over here, the grapes here, lemons and limes. Celery and carrots, and then the hard-boiled eggs are in here. So depending on how it fits in the refrigerator, these could be subject to change. I'm gonna direct you back to the fridge. Obviously, there's still other things that I have that aren't in like a container type of thing. They're in like their own containers. So those gotta go back in too. Honestly, what I would recommend for next time though, I probably should have kept some of those things in the refrigerator because like a lot of it has just been sitting out getting warm, and that's not really smart. So if you do this, just take out the items that you're organizing and put the rest of them back in the refrigerator until you're ready to do the organization all over again.
You know what? I'm hungry.
All right, here's the refrigerator again. I have the juice section already done. Now to fill the rest. So, I'm going to get this back in on top. So, what I would like to do is when I get the actual container for the fresh eggs, the non-hard-boiled eggs, I'll put that underneath this and stack them together since that one has a lid. But for right now, I'm just going to put this in there. Vegetables. Ugh, I'm gonna do this. Already, I don't think they're gonna all fit in here, so. By the way, all the way at the bottom is where I keep the meat at, so I just put those back in so that they don't get too warm. So that's basically how it's gonna go, except it'll be the clear container. This is why I needed more stuff that were stackable.
One little finger, part two.
So I think I'm gonna try and put these together. Change this from out of here to space behind there that I didn't want to use because I didn't want something to get like lost back there and I didn't remember where it was at. I didn't remember it was in there. But because I primarily use that for this, when I take this out to remake, those will be right behind it for me to use. Oranges and kiwi and another one of the white bowls. The white bowls are kind of lifesavers right now. I've come to the conclusion that my water thing is absolutely not fitting in this refrigerator, which really sucks. I kind of wish I didn't clean that out because I was sure I was going to use that, not realizing how much space it was going to take, like all the other stuff was going to take up. But that's absolutely not going in. So I'm just gonna have to find another space for that. Waters in on that side. For now, it is what it is. We'll just drink what's there. And I don't think that looks too bad. Don't think it looks bad. I'm gonna just leave it like this. I'm not gonna give like a close up of everything because I want to finish this out first, and then I'll kind of just go through and let you kind of see a little bit closer in at how it all looks. But this is it so far, and tomorrow will probably be the next clip of me actually going through with it, so you'll see it right now.